Fused Deposition Modeling, or FDM, also known as Fused Filament Fabrication, is likely the most well-known 3D printing technology, seeing as it's commonly used in home printers. But its capabilities extend far beyond this. It's also well-suited for the industrial market. FDM's strength leads to low lead-time quality prints that retain mechanical properties over time, in just about any geometry you have in mind, and using a wide range of durable materials. FDM is a stable technology which makes it possible to repeatedly produce the same parts, ultimately ensuring high quality. These capabilities make FDM a trusted go-to for industries that require certified manufacturing, such as aerospace and automotive. It's also a popular choice for prototypes across the board. Let's take a look at how it works. FDM is an extrusion technology based on thermoplastic modeling filament. In other words, a plastic material that can be heated to a semi-liquid state. A temperature-controlled extrusion head then draws the part and it supports layer by layer. The support structure is built in a water-soluble material that is later removed to reveal the finished part. The technology is a great match for aerospace in particular because of its process stability, repeatability, and use of high-grade engineering plastics. FDM is also a good choice if you're looking to produce complex end-use parts in small series and prototypes for form, fit, and function testing. A big advantage when working with FDM is the extensive range of available materials. This includes plastics with excellent properties such as flame retardancy, handling heavy loads, and more. It is also possible to produce components that are composed of various parts printed in different materials. When you start designing for FDM, there are a few key points to keep in mind. 1. The minimum wall thickness will mostly depend on the size of the component, varying between 1 mm for smaller parts and 6 mm for larger prints. 2. Because the material is deposited layer by layer, the build orientation influences the strength of the part. A part will be weaker in the Z height, so be sure to consider this in your design. 3. As with many other 3D printing technologies, it is necessary to include support structures for some FDM printed parts. This will depend on the geometry, but a good rule of thumb to keep in mind is that support structures are needed if the part walls are less than a 45 degree angle to one another and bear the weight of another part element from above. And that's a wrap on FDM, a stable technology that produces high quality parts and is likely to continue bringing serious value to the additive manufacturing scene as innovation advances.